poopy stuff in there and in there.
There's poopy stuff in there?
Yep, and that's disgusting.
It's disgusting?
Yep.
Okay, I'll remember. Kids are officially at school. They had, what, like 3 days off? 4 days? Oh, like a 5 day weekend, basically. And they're back at school. I have to go get gas because I am almost on E. I am very bad at remembering when to put gas on the phone, or on the phone, on the car. So I'm gonna go and fill up and finally catch up on all my TV shows because I haven't been able to watch them. Oh my gosh, are you gonna take off the front end of my car, Mr. Truck? Nope, you didn't. That was very close though. And I hate this intersection right here. It's the worst to get out of because you can't see crap because of the fence for the golf course. It's a big pile of poop, but gotta get gas. Look at those gas prices. They are so flipping beautiful. I'm gonna estimate, say about $45. We'll see. But I'm saying 45. Ooh, look at that. And then I'll round it off to 50. Well, I got this and then it started to leak out, so I decided it was time to stop. Seeing that full line is the best feeling in the world. And so yeah, gas isn't that bad because normally it costs about close to $70 to fill up the tank at Chevron. And now it's like 50, so can't complain. And they're only getting lower. And if I really wanted to be stingy, I could have just got the cheaper one. But we've learned from experience that the higher the gas, the longer it lasts in our car, no matter how much driving we're doing. So we just go out, because technically you're saving money in the long run. Rather getting the cheap gas and having to fill up twice in the 2 weeks, or getting the expensive gas and only having to fill up once. So mommy is trying to get into shape and get a little more healthier because, like I said, these past few years since my dad has passed away have been really tough for me. I've kind of just let myself go. I don't like where I've gone. I've gained literally probably about 30 pounds. Like, I went to the doctor yesterday for my pre-op appointment and my scale was just like, no, no. Like, what I weighed at the doctor was what I weighed when I was about ready to give birth to Alex. Yeah, and so not a pretty sight. So I've decided that I can't have any more excuses. I can't, like, I get on this track of running and exercising and all that, and then I stop. And then when I stop, I go back to my horrible eating habits. So I'm gonna start out small. Zoe and I, my little partner in crime over there, we're on our way to the dog place that she did her training at, and I'm gonna go and get her fitted for another harness because she ate her harness like off of her. I don't even know how she freaking managed to do that, but she chewed her harness off, so we gotta go get a new harness. And then she has a pinch collar because she likes to like lunge, and so I need to go and get that fixed as well. And that stupid car was about ready to jump out in front of me. Anyways, get that fixed as well, and then we literally live right across the street from a park and a dog park, so we can start going out and doing a little more exercising and walking, and just start with walking, you know. And that's what everybody says, you gotta start out slow, you gotta start walking, you gotta start that first before you will notice any changes, and kind of get your body into the habit of moving a little more often. So that's what I am gonna start doing, because I can't do this anymore. Like, my arms are strong, my legs need to get a little more stronger. I have huge thighs. I never had a role in my life before, and here I am with roles, and I'm just unfit. I feel exhausted when I mop the kitchen. Yeah, when I mop the kitchen, I'm like out of breath. It's not a good thing. And so I'm over it. I'm gonna do better and get fitter and just try to be a little more healthier. So this girl right there, she's gonna be my healthy one. She's gonna go walking with me. Hi, Zoe. You can go walking with me? You don't like
like being in the car, do you? Nope, you don't.
So, I don't think my last video recorded, so I'll try this again.
But I'm not gonna be able to vlog too much of me walking with Zoe because it is super windy. But she is doing pretty good. She still wants, see, there it is. She still wants to like bark at everybody. And I'm just trying to find a way to curb that because I don't appreciate the barking. Especially if she's gonna be for Alex, we need to make sure she's nice to people and doesn't bark at them. But it's tiring, it's exhausting. Trying to get her off the pole. Man, I'm getting my steps in today, that's for sure.
Maybe we'll take her. Just focus on making it to the car.
Mommy, maybe on Saturday? I don't have anything on Saturday?
I don't think so.
If I don't, can we go to the dog park with me and Zoe?
Yeah, we could do that.
Okay. Nathan, on Saturday, this Saturday, if I don't have anything, we can go to the dog park with Zoe. No, we're going to do that after school.
Can you please zip your coat? Thank you.
Mom, can you hold me on the cliff?
Yep, you're good still. Just walk. You're good. Focus. Yep. Now start turning. Turning around the corner. Mom, you got this. Turn around the corner.
Where?
You see the crack in front of you? As long as you don't walk on that, you're good.
Today is Dr. Seuss's birthday, and we went and we had breakfast with Alex this morning. Couldn't really record because it was busy and crazy. So many kids everywhere, so many parents, and it was kind of like we were like rushed so more people could come in and eat. But I had to leave to take Mason to school, and then Alex had an accident. We went outside to play, and his walker must have like gotten stuck in the grass, and he just flipped over and fell on his side. He's okay. I think it scared him more than anything. And yes, I sound funny. I'm sick. I'm sick again. Hopefully this is the last sickness I have till next winter. Doubt it with my children because they're always bringing crap home. But now I'm going back to the school. They're going to do like the story time. And so I get to go and read Dr. Seuss books to his classroom. So I'm pretty excited. I don't know if I'll be able to record there either because not having like the other kids' permission to be in the videos. But we'll see what I can come up with. And I don't think it's going to be very enjoyable to listen to me read a book sounding like this. I sound absolutely terrible. And yes, my nose is completely full of boogers, just in case you were wondering. Then, update on my surgery. My surgery went well. It was actually a week ago today that I had it done. I was in and out. I felt good. I've just been cramping a little bit. But these past couple of days have been nothing but amazing. Like, I feel so much better. I feel like my energy's up. I feel like my like mental state is better. I don't feel so like sad and depressed. I feel more awake and energized and happy. So maybe it was just the birth control that was having me like feel really down in the dumps. But as of now, I go in for a follow-up post-op appointment next week, and then go from there. But as of now, I'm doing great. Surgery was great. And so now I'm just in the recovery stage. But things seem to be going pretty well. We came to go for that dinner, and they are booked solid. They said so that they're not going to be able to take any more people till about 7:30. And right now it's like 6 o'clock. And so I guess the owner said that he was going to make room for us because it's an event regarding Alex. So we'll see how that goes. He told us just to hang out and wait just for a minute.
Beautiful. Who won?
Me.
Good job. That one. Is it good?
Yeah.
Do you like your pizza?
Yep.
Yeah?
Mason, what did you get?
Macaroni and bread and broccoli.
That's a lot of macaroni.
Mom?
What? Look. What? Look. Your pizza?
Yeah, how many did they get?
They gave you count them.
Four
pizzas.
Oh, you're the best.
And what?
What did you got?
Right now we just have some bread. We're still waiting on our food.
Mom.
Huh?
What did you got?
I ordered shrimp. But I'm
all tied in it.
I don't even know where it is. Where is it? I'll take him.
Dinner is served. We have two beautiful children.
Daddy, look. Look, Daddy.
Good job, buddy.
Not even doing it the right way.
Mommy, what's this? What's this?
Thank you.
What's this? What's this?
It's another one.
What was this?
Read it. What does it say?
It says blue letter.
Read it.
It says blue letter.
Good job.
It says blue letter.
Okay, write the blue letters.
What? Uh-oh.
Thank you.
Hey. Look at it. Look
at it. Look at it. Look at
it. Yay.
Love you.
How's your breakfast?
Good.
You like it? What about you? Do you like yours?
Yep.
Delicious pancakes?
Okay, sip.
Do you like your breakfast yet?
It's very good. Well, I haven't tried it yet, but it's
Do you like
good.
Your breakfast, Mommy?
Daddy's breakfast and Mommy's breakfast.
Hey!
So we decided to go out and about today, and the main roads are closed due to, I guess, like really bad flooding. It rained so much last night. So I'm guessing that's probably what it is, but pretty much 40th Ave and Washington is flooded, and then Attanum, another busy road, is flooded. Down towards 72nd and West Valley area is flooded. Everywhere is flooded. I think we're gonna go to the mall, walk, and get some exercise, and kind of just get out of the house.
Mommy?
The children. What's up?
Why are we going to the mall?
To walk.
I'm bored of walking.
Well, it's good for you. It makes
tired
you look strong.
It makes
you walk so well.
It makes you get some exercise of your running. If you
and then you can work on your trick.
Yep.
We can. You want to show the YouTube family your trick?
What?
You want to show them your trick? Your super cool trick you can do in your walker?
Yeah.
Yeah. So when we get to the mall, we'll show them, okay?
Okay.
Alex has been walking so much better. He's now able to do little tricks in his walker. It's the little things that I guess bring him joy and make him look at this sucky situation as something fun, and he can do his own thing, and I don't know, but he loves it. It's so windy, huh?
Yeah.
Can you make it in this? You can handle it?
Yeah.
You got it?
Yeah.
Alex's? It doesn't go down anymore, it's short. Come on.
Oh.
Already demanding money back there. Yeah. But it's so windy.
Woo!
He's getting too excited. Slow down. Okay, try it again. Woo!
Where do you want to go?
Just keep going.
Want to go in here?
Not right now. They look cute.
There's booby stuff in there and there.
There's
and
booby
that,
stuff in there?
Yep, and that's disgusting.
It's disgusting?
Yep.
Okay, I'll remember that.
Daddy?
We'll see when you're 18. We'll see if
Daddy?
Is,
it's so gross.
Not even 18.
Oh my god, somewhere not supposed to go, I'll get
it. Convincing Hector to buy something is like pulling teeth from a child. He won't do it. He absolutely won't do it. He needs to. He needs to buy himself something.
Stop. Let go, let go, let go. Okay. Is the gray better or the black better?
I like both. Both.
I'm not spending $50 on
that. Go get the black one. Go get the black one.
Better.
I like the black one. The green one would be nicer for summer though. Because it's a lighter color. I want him to get both of them. Something for him at least. We'll see. We decided to come to Costco. Was coming to Costco a mistake? It was so busy here. It's insane. Huh. Ew, don't show people your mouth. That's gross. Are you eating a coconut macaroon? Ew. It's gross. Yeah, grab a couple if you want. Daddy's gotta get his favorite. Grapefruit.
Single time, guys.
Right,
Mason.
No more.
We're only coming in for a couple things.
We were only coming in for milk and bread. We walk out with all that.
Bobby.
We are home. It has been a long day. We got a lot accomplished at the grocery store, and we spent about $140 today. But our fridge is full, and it's got pretty much all like healthy vegetables, fruits, salads, things like that, because we are done with the bad eating. Done. Just done. It is loaded. Strawberries, grapefruits, eggs, you name it, it's all in there.
Those.
What? Did you miss me? Oh, what are you doing, you freak?
What do you smell? What is it? What do you smell?
She's a weird duck.
What's up?
Whoa! Don't lick my makeup.
You crazy girls. Who's a crazy girls? Look at her. Who's a crazy girls? What are those?
Dinner is done. Our bellies are full. And we gotta get ready for tomorrow because it is school.
No more school.
We'll have school for a long time.
No more school. Cancel it.
No.
Yes.
No.
Cancel it.
No, I can't. I gotta go. Oh. And Mason has a dentist, and my lipstick's all coming off. Mason has a dentist appointment in the morning. He has got a cavity in between his back molar. Like the teeth, like in between the teeth. So we still get that fixed. We tried before, like a month ago, but for some reason, he wasn't numbing. Like the medication wasn't numbing his mouth. Like he could still feel when they poke him. So now they're gonna have to do it, but he's gonna have to be like put to sleep to do it. So we get to be there at 7:45 in the morning with all kids. And then after Mason's all set, situated, and taken care of, either Hector or I will take him to school because Hector's going to take the day off to
to be there because you need to have two people there at all times for this thing. So he doesn't really know exactly what's going to be going on tomorrow. He just knows he's going to be going back, and they're going to give him some funny medicine. So help me.
Yeah.
Mom, you don't like the sun.
No, Mom doesn't like the sun.
Why?
I don't know.
Because it's too bright?
Yeah.
Oh. But sometimes like the sun.
Should have worn a hat.
I know. So we are off to the dentist. Mason has a dentist appointment this morning. I don't know how well that is going to go. And the weird thing is Mason has the cavities and Alex doesn't, which they get their teeth brushed the same time, same day, everything. Yet Mason's mouth is like way worse than Alex's. It's very strange. And Mason eats better than Alex. And so they just said that like, it's true that there's just like bad bacteria in your saliva that causes you to have these cavities. So if you have cavities out there and you brush your teeth, it's probably not your fault. It's probably your genetics and saliva and all that fun stuff.
Hey,
so
Bobby.
Yeah, but that's what we're off to right now. I hope he does good.
I love you.
I love you. You feel okay?
Yeah.
Yeah? Don't leave. You gotta leave it in there so you don't bite your cheek.
Okay.
Are you sleepy?
A little bit.
A little bit? Do you want to go home and lay down?
Yeah, and watch a movie.
And watch a movie? I think that's a good idea. You made me make you some soup?
Yeah.
Some chicken noodle soup?
Okay, let me go home, okay?
Okay.
Mommy?
What, buddy?
Can we get a toy? Because that's what my dad said.
Dad said you get a toy?
Yeah, I told Roy.
When did he tell you this?
Today!
Where was I?
Hey, Mace. What did I say?
I'm a teller.
That's a teller.
That's right, I'm a teller. Mommy, can we?
Once we rest a little bit, okay?
Okay. Mommy?
Huh?
I love you.
I love you,
Daddy?
Too.
Daddy?
So.
I'm never coming to Toys R Us with you ever again. Why do we have tacos? What's this?
It's a taco takeover.
Don't taco about it. Play it. That is Ready, set, taco. Take an order, ticket, grab a taco shell, and be the first to stuff it with all the correct toppings. It's fast, fun, and nacho average game.
Nacho average game.
This is so dumb.
So we decided we'd go to Toys R Us because Mason did really good at his dentist appointment, and Hector promised somebody a toy.
I get it.
After his game, or after his appointment. Mommy. So we come and we buy Pie Face. Finally, they have it back in stock. Hector wanted Sorry.
How do you do this?
Alex wants a taco game. And then we have,
Sorry.
It's called Wet Head. It's a water roulette game. So, it shall be some fun. So, I do not know how well you can see me, but we are heading to go to a basketball game. For Mr. Ike, it's the Mr. Ike boys against the staff of Eisenhower. So we are getting ready to go to that. It's just gonna be me and Alex today because Mason from the dentist, he's like really tired and still a little loopy. It's kind of weird. So it's just gonna be me, Alex, and I. I finally did get ready because I feel like since it's going to be about Alex, I should at least look like a mom. Well, I would look like a mom if I didn't have any makeup on, but I'm at least more presentable and put together. So we are on our way, heading to the basketball game.
This is your brother's.
Oh, you found it?
Yeah.
He's gonna be so happy to see that.
I know, they found it at Testa's and they were like, all right, you know. Here is 17 back.
Are you gonna give it to your brother or are you gonna keep it?
I'm gonna get this to my brother.
Yeah, you give it to him?
You're a good brother.
Hey.
Hey.
Who do you think's gonna win? The blue or red? Your color? Yeah? I think so too. How many points do you think they're gonna win by? By like a lot? 10? 10 points? You think they're gonna win by 10 points?
Yes!
High five. Good job.
Blue mommy!
What?
I don't even know what he does.
Cheese.
Seriously.
I don't know.
Thank you.
between the third and fourth quarter, but I don't have anybody to record for me, so we're going to try to wing it and do the best we can, and maybe we'll take the camera out. Everybody can see us. Yeah?
No.
We have about 40 seconds before the showtime.
This awesome ball, this was what his gift was. Everybody signed it for him. Look at that. Look. Everybody signed it. Pretty cool.
Hey, camera.
Where's the crowd? McDonald went to see it.
Is he your favorite?
Yeah.
Yep. 26 seconds left. Showered, I'm in my jams, I'm ready to go to bed. Alex laid down and he literally just knocked out in the first 5 seconds of being home. He was that tired. So we're gonna call it a day. I'm gonna get some sleep. It's almost 9 o'clock. I'm tired. Daddy's tired and the boys are sleeping. So it's a perfect time to go to bed early.